2021 salary report. The fastest growing salaries by occupation. What jobs are currently growing? What jobs are kind of falling behind? Okay, we're still growing. It's okay. I have a job still. Within the next 10 years, a lot of jobs are going to become automated. It's a discussion I've been having with a lot of my colleagues and friends is, how is this going to look? What does this mean for everyone? Well, for one, it means a lot of upskilling. With that comes a lot of new jobs as well. The technology that is automating and maintaining the systems of jobs that were once done by humans will need to be maintained. There is a ton of job opportunities that will come out in the tech industry because of these automations. I know obviously there is pros and cons to both sides, but today I really want to talk to you more specifically about some tech jobs that are set to boom within the decade. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Leave in the comments other topics you want me to cover, whether it be future of tech, coding, career, salary, you know, any of the above, leave down below. Okay, let's get right into it. Recently, I was reading a really interesting report by Dice, which was their 2021 salary report. And I'll link it down below so you can check it out as well. It has tons of different information and data in it, which really covers in detail what jobs are currently growing, what jobs are kind of falling behind, and it's really interesting. And I actually want to pull something up on screen that I was reading about it, which is the fastest growing salaries by occupation. Now keep in mind, once again, these are specific around tech jobs. Okay, let's start with number 10. I think there's 10 of them, and work our way up to number one. So they say number 10 being data architect with a 3.2% increase yearly for salary. Cybersecurity engineer, data engineer, web developer, business analyst, cloud engineer, technical support engineer, DevOps engineer, data scientist, and first is cybersecurity analyst. No surprise here, I think cybersecurity analyst comes in at number one with a 16.3% annual salary increase, because as you can see down below, cybersecurity engineer, it's not that high up, but what has happened is there's been so much demand for cybersecurity that a lot more of the junior roles have been filled or starting to get filled, but now we have this gap on more senior level roles such as a cybersecurity analyst, that kind of space or that those people are really missing still. These are some of the tech jobs that are set to boom within the next decade. And I mean, as you can see, it's pretty obvious from data, cybersecurity, business analyst, and a lot of cloud. It makes sense. It's kind of the direction we are headed. Any of these roles, you will definitely be safe if you get into these roles or if you are navigating towards these roles to be able to continue to grow within the tech industry. Now, that being said, if you aren't in these roles, does that mean you won't grow? Does that mean your job is just going to disappear? Not necessarily. What I think it means more than anything is that you need to be open to continuing to learn and evolve as technology and really our world does as well. More often than not, if you aren't continuing to learn and upskill, you are going to fall behind. And I think that really speaks more true now than ever, especially with technology being so quick paced and really integrated in every part of our daily lives, that we really need to, I'm not saying spend your weekends and evenings continuing to learn, but just be aware of what's coming down the pipeline with new technologies. Even if it's not necessarily of interest to you, just having that awareness, I think, is huge. Okay, I also recently found, which I want to pull up on screen here too, this really, really interesting tool. It's futureskills.pearson.com. And what I really like about it is they've built this system where you can go and explore the statistics of how likely your job is to be around in the future, which is pretty crazy. Okay, I'm gonna pull it up on screen here. So let's enter, let's start with US. And let's see what happens here. Job title. I mean, they're obviously collecting data on this, so you don't have to be accurate on it. I'm going to be somewhat accurate just in order to, you know, help them with who's really going to their website and what they're looking at. Okay, so I found this website a while ago and I think it's really cool just to see, get a sense. I mean, obviously this is just one report based on some certain data, so don't, you know, hold your whole career or life to it, but I just think it's really interesting. So, okay, here, let's get personal. So I'm 29 right now, as you know, or maybe you didn't know, now you know. In 2030, you will be 38 years old. Skills that would prepare you most for your job as a software developer is learning strategy, fluency in ideas, and technology design. They also go in talking about what does this mean, which I think is really cool. So they really break down what skills will be important based on the role you are currently in. and then the percent of chance of growth by 2030. So software developers have a 61.5 chance of growth by 2030. Okay, we're still growing, it's okay. I have a job still. And then you can see how your results compare. Okay, so as you can see, we have different roles here. Information security analysts have a 62% growth. This is what I am. Database admin have a 58% chance. Computer occupations, all other, 58. So it's pretty cool. Okay, anyways, I'll link that down below. I just think it's a really interesting resource to kind of play around with and get a sense of where your interests are and what growth rate and potential they really have for the future. You know, you choose a role hopefully based on what you're interested in and what you want to do with your time. You want to enjoy your time and do something that makes you happy. But at the end of the day, you also want to do something that pays you. You need to eat at the end of the day. Maybe you have a family, maybe you have ambitions for travel or whatever it is. So you want a role that really fulfills all of your needs, hopefully, and one that sticks around for a while. So I thought this was really interesting to play around with. And at the end of the day too, I really don't want you to base your career on what is trending right now for a tech role, because realistically, what is trending now might not even be trending in 5 years. So you can't really base it on that, which goes back to the whole point of, more than anything, you really just need to continue to learn and grow your skills. Do what is interesting to you. Find what your passion is. For example, right now I'm doing software development, but I have a huge interest in blockchain development. So outside of work hours or on my learning hours at work, I've been learning a lot about blockchain, and it's something I find really interesting. Now, is it related to my job? Not specifically, but do I see a potential for me to go that way? Yeah, I kind of do. And same with things like Web3 and different technologies, just exploring them and finding the fun in them, reading different articles on them. And more than anything, I hope this video just sparks your interest, that realizing that you don't need to, you know, do a full 180 into a job that's going to be in demand in 10 years, because we really don't know. But I also want to share with you some areas that they do, based on data, see a lot of potential growth in. Okay, I'll leave you on that high note, but I'm curious to know, what are some jobs that you think will boom in the next decade? Do you agree or disagree with the ones that I listed at the beginning? If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Before we go, I want to say a big shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you. I see you. I love you. You all are just honestly amazing. One of my favorite things is when I'm reading through the comments and seeing some of you respond or help other people out to their questions before I got to the answer. And I just think it's really cool, the community we are building. So, okay, I know I'm being sentimental, but I just had to say a big shout out to you all. I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.